start, I want to welcome everybody to the Health and Wellbeing Board. Got quite a crowded agenda and lots of additional bits of paper that have circulated. Apologies for that. We need to be out of here by 6, because there's another committee meeting coming in, and there's some of us involved in, so probably just stay around. Just want to give advance notice of just a slight change in the batting order of the agenda. I'm going to switch items 6 and 8. Item 8 where 6 is, because Julia needs to get away. Julia, so through the urgent business. So we'll have item 8 there. Everyone okay with that? Yes? Right, item 1 is declarations of interest. Do we have any? Anyone wishes to declare? Okay, thank you. I will declare an interest in item 7, the pharmaceutical needs assessment, because my wife's a pharmacist. So, so, item 2 is apologies for absence.
Could we have the mic on, please? Because I can't hear. Sorry.
Okay. More apologies. Right, minutes. Item 3, the minutes of the meeting held on the 17th of September. Can I sign those as an accurate record? Agreed? That takes us on to item 4, update on response to better care fund submission. Graham.
Thank you. have valued that element in how the student put 3 million in the year and the risk shared. If we don't achieve any of that, these 2.75 million from the CCG and 600,000 from the Rural Council. Obviously, if we achieve an element of that 5%, then the proportion of that can be held and paid. And again, a quick reminder that if we don't achieve all or part of that performance target, then the money that are retained are paid direct to the acute shortage to offset the risk of the non-delivery. Can I move to the board? Okay, so just try to pull out from the confirmation that we had from NHS England just a few of the quotes that were actually in our feedback. So they're just summarised there for you. So we had some really positive feedback, which we were really pleased with. I have to say we are really pleased with the proof and support. So they said that we have a strong plan, which was ambitious and well structured. It did acknowledge that Rural has the highest emergency admission rate in the country, and that they were pleased that we stretched above the 3.5% target to 5% to acknowledge that. have final clarity of those arrangements by the beginning of December, by the 4th of December. We are driving forward now with service redesign, and I've just provided a summary for you, which is this coloured one, which is the schemes list, which I know is a very busy diagram, so I'm not to attempt to put that on over there. Very quick reminder for people, on the left-hand column, probably need to put a title on this so it's easier for people. On the left-hand column, just a reminder, there are the four themed areas: early intervention and prevention, keeping people in their local communities, step-up, step-down services, and then mental health, including drug and alcohol services. Those are the four themed areas that we prioritise the service redesign and the investment against. And that gives you the detail running across in terms of the amount of funding, the assessment of risk, etc. What Sarah and I have done is the green column at the end with a few bits of amber in on the far right hand side, we've added a current progress column for you and tried to backlight that so red out the green against any progress. And what we're looking to do from the next health and well board meeting is to actually spend the time giving you a more detailed overview of the scheme progress and help you get your heads into what's happening and whether you want to make any comments on the Health and Wellbeing Board against that.
review. That's very helpful. Are there any questions, comments? Anything you want to ask me? Go.
Sorry, it's very difficult to check this paper in the program. I appreciate lots of support from the GC. I'm interested in a particular column, and it isn't coloured. It isn't green or red or amber. But it's the column in the middle of the sheet about redesign, which is about the development level of the student. The two stars, it's there over my phone, so if that helps you find it. Looking across the column at the top where the labels are, it's development of the student. Now, if I'm not wrong, just desperately adding on what good the twos and threes.
Okay.
And it seems to come to about 14 or 15 million worth of schemes are either in twos or on threes, and therefore, so maybe too anxious too early, perhaps I should look at it, the movement from a one to a two and a three.
Okay, so I can answer that for you, okay. again, to tell us a bit about the detail we want to hear. Linked to the previous presentation we did, which was the focus session for the care fund, prior to the filing of the submission, there was a more detailed paper that we had in the submission, which you should have access to, that can be sent again. Basically, we assessed against each scheme the time scale, and there was a key on that that said if it was going to be in place before the end of this financial year, it was a scheme one, so it's very fast. It was going to be in place for April, it was a two, and if it was going to be into the first quarter of next year, it was a three. So that's where the items of impact and deliverability, that's the one, two, three.
I just want to understand the relationship. This key number 10 talks about carers. I'm going down a little bit down the left hand side of that page now. But when I look at the clinical commissioning group chart about support in the community, about helping the carers, and I remember my turn about two-thirds of the way down that page on the left, so probably Andrew will do that. I'm trying to understand the relationship between the progress that the city is making to identify carers and supporting them, which is there, and the significance of us and how it relates to carers and drug commissioning here.
Okay.
None of it's new money.
So absolutely, there are 6 juices and top slide.
sort of headings on the left-hand side which kind of suggest outcomes that I could certainly understand, like keeping people alone with communities. But it just to play really, when we have reports back to the Health and Wellbeing Board, clearly we need to have all this data. But for me, it's about how the outcomes could be better for people of the world. So anything that we can include in this which kind of explains how outcomes are getting better. Of course, I appreciate it.
this legislation, I'm going to focus on four key elements. The first element is the doctor contact, second, family justice, thirdly, children's special educational needs and or disabilities, and then some general provision around the welfare of children. I think the key themes that emerge from this legislation is speeding things up, focusing on outcomes, and giving children and parents much more control and say over what happens. So, in terms of adoption contact, these were aspects of the new legislation which were implemented on the 21st of July this year. So, there's a provision around fostering for adoption, where the focus is on placing children with respective doctors. The legislation actually removes the specific wording in respect to children's ethnicity to try and secure an ethnically appropriate match for children. And there's some previous guidance that will support achieving the right balance. We can spend years and years trying to find exactly the right match when you're missing the point that the child actually needs to be secure and stable in a loving family. And so more pervasive in that respect, focuses on the child's needs over the doctor's needs.